गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल। आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू इन टुडेज लेक्चर। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी वर सीन दैट द वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ द कॉन्क्रीट मिक्सर्स, देन व्हाट आर द वेरियस वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल्स, हाउ द कॉन्क्रीट इज मिक्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मिक्सर्स। So all the classifications and their descriptions we were seen in the last lecture. In today's lecture, we will see the remaining part, that is some of the technical specifications of the different types of concrete mixers. So mixer is a machine or device by which we can mix all the ingredient of the concrete such as cement, sand, aggregate and water for to get the a dense concrete for any types of the work. So that is known as the mixers. Then also we was discuss in detail regarding about the continuous mixers, the application of these particular mixers, where it is applicable, then how the concrete is mixed with the help of continuous mixers, under which circumstances we have to use the continuous mixers, we was seen in the last lectures. Then also we was discuss regarding about one of the most important, that is the batch mixers. We have two types of the batch mixers, that is pan mixers and drum mixers. Then in case of the drum mixers, we have three types of sub type of the drum mixers, that is tilting type, non tilting and reversing type. So almost all the theoretical portion we was completed in the last lectures. Okay, so this was we discussed in the last lectures about the in the first column. If you see here the pictures of the drum mixers, that is the non tilting mixers. In the second column, if you see here some of the characteristics, important characteristics. So in case of the non tilting mixers, what we observe in case of the non tilting mixers, a single drum rotating about a horizontal axis. So in case of the non tilting mixers, the rotation is allowed in only horizontal axis, about the horizontal axis. Then it has a fixed blade which work the concrete towards the discharge end of the mixers, okay, in order to provide a rapid rate of the discharge. So where medium type of concrete is in, concrete is going on the site, we have to use the non tilting type of the mixers. For example, in case of the road constructions, in case of the rigid pavement. Now this is one of the most important, you can say, the equipment by which we can do the constructions of the rigid pavement. Okay, now if you see another type of the drum mixers, that is tilting type drum mixers. So the rotation is allowed in clockwise or in anticlockwise directions in the both horizontal as well as in vertical axis. They are most suitable for concrete with large size aggregate, and hence they have a rapid discharge rate and are suitable for low workability concrete. Okay, so this type of mixer is generally used for the purpose of low workability. Then if you see in case of the internal blades, so it has an internal blades for the purpose of lift and trouble the ingredient into the itself. Okay, so with the help of the blades which is provided inside this particular drum, which rotate the all ingredient of the concrete, and you will get a good concrete at the from the outlet of this particular tilting type drum mixers. Then also we were seen that regarding about the reversing mixers. So in case of the reversing mixers, this is similar with the non tilting type of the mixers, but only the difference is that rotation in one direction for mixing and in the reverse directions of the discharge. Okay. So the rotation is allowed in case of the reversing mixers in the reverse directions of the discharge of the concrete at the outlet. So that is the difference between non-tilting and reversing mixers. Then one set of the blade exit for the each operations. Okay. Then provide efficient mixing with a very little, you can see the bleed up within the mixers. And this type of the reversing mixers are suitable with dry concrete mixes. So this is the discussion we had in the last lectures. Now in today's lecture, if you see here, this is the remaining parts as far as the engineering concern. Okay, for any types of the civil engineering project, if you want to construct a bridge, piers, if you want to construct a dams, okay, now if you want to construct a high rise buildings in case of the urban areas, or in case of the, you can say, the runway for the aeroplane take off and landing, okay, we have to construct a runway. Okay, so the first step is that we have to mix the concrete with the proper suitable machinery. Okay, so the challenges in front of that is in front of all of us is that we have to select a proper concrete mixer. Okay, so that is the biggest challenges in front of us. We have to use a good type of the mixers, and three things are very important in case of any types of the, you can say, the any type of project. Okay, the first thing is that the concrete should have a good quality. Then we have to use a slump value as per the IS 456-2000, and we have to maintain the specific value of the slumps and durable concrete. Whenever you are entering into the lecture, remember that the unmute should be there. Okay, mute should be there. Whenever you entering into the class, always remember that you enter with mute conditions. Okay, so we will discuss regarding about the technical specifications. Okay, so I am talking about the quality of the concrete. Okay, the thing is that our objective behind any type of the project is that we should minimize the total cost of the constructions and maximize the net benefit. Okay, so to maximize the net benefit, to maximize the net profit from any type of the project, the thing is that we have to use certain kind of machinery which will produce a good quality of the concrete mixes. So as far as the civil engineering point of view, before going into detail for any type of the project, you should know which type of the machinery we have to use for a particular project. Okay, so we will see some of the technical specifications you should know as per the civil engineering point of view. So as per this drum type mixers, we will have a certain you can say the technical specifications. Now in the first column, if you see here, we have the type of the mixers. The tilting type mixers is there. The drum capacity of this particular mixers is 90 liters. The drum speed is 18 to 200 rpm. Okay, in 1 minute this drum will rotate about 18 to 20 revolution per minute. Then concrete mixing, it will take 180 seconds. Then these are the another technical specification, but we should know this first three technical specifications as far as the civil engineering point of view. And the another thing is that the primer, that is The electric motor, which is used for the purpose of rotations, it require 2 HP. Then for the purpose of the horizontal transportation, we require the wheel. So 2 number of pneumatic type of the wheel which required. Then if you see the dimensions for this particular type of the drum type mixers, the length, width and the height 1600 and 920 mm. Okay, so these are the technical specifications about the drum type mixer. Okay, then the another type of the mixers, if you see here, we have the another mixers, that is 10 by 7 hydraulic mixers. Now in the first column and in the second column, if you see here, there are two types of this particular mixers: reversing mixers, casting type and mild steel type. So if you see here, for the first type of the mixers, the drum capacity is approximately 10 effective mix with 7, and in case of MS type also, then the drum speed is 20 rpm and in case of mix is same 20 rpm. Then the concrete mixing time is 180 seconds approximately, and in case of MS type is also 180. Then the motor type is, it is required 6 HP one motor, or the 5 HP, which required 3-phase electric motor. So it required the 3-phase. Then in case of the MS type of the reversing type of the mixers, 6 HP motor required, and we should have the 3-phase electric motor. Then if you see here, the overall dimension for this particular type of the mixers is length, width, okay, and the height. For the first casting type, reversing type of the mixers is 3400 length, and width is 2080, which is an mm. And in case of the MS type is, if you see here, 2900 length and 2000 mm is the width, and the height is 2600 mm. So these things we should know, because for producing the volume of the concrete, we should know this type of the, you can say, the technical specifications. Then the another type of the mixers is the mechanical type of the mixers. Now this is the another type of the reversing mixers. Again, if you see here, the concrete mixing time 180, and in case of MS also 180. Then drum speed is, the as per the IS standard, in case of the casting type, generally 20 to 18 rpm. The overall dimensions and the type of the motor is also specified in these particular tables. So this type of the technical specification we should know. Then the another type of the portable mixers, if you see here, the drum capacity is 90 liters, then drum speed 18 to 20 rpm, the concrete mixing time is 180 seconds. Okay, now this type of mixer, which is required 3 HP motor, then wheel require 4 numbers, and the dimensions is given here: length, width and the height. So these are the another technical specification for the drive mixers. The loading height, that is the mixing drum from the ground up the height is 1360 mm. Then the another thing is that we should know the drum length, then the driving top speed also is given, then guide roller is also given, then length, width, height and dimensions. So these things are we should know about each and every mixers. Then the reversible concrete mixers. Now again, if you see here, the descriptions, we have different types of the model in case of the reversible concrete mixers: RM550, then RM800, RM1050, then RM1400. the hopper capacity and the batch capacity is also given. In case of the first type of the model, the 550 liter, then 800, 1050 liters, then 1400 liters. Then the batch capacity is 450 liters, 600, 750 and 900 liters. Then the machine output is given, means in 1 hour how much concrete meter cube of the concrete you can mix with the help of the reversible concrete mixers. So for the first type of the mixer, 8 to 10 meter cube of the concrete is the output in 1 hour. Then in case of this type of the model, 10 to 12 meter cube of the concrete you can get in 1 hour. Then in case of this RM model 1050, you will be get 12 to 15 meter cube of the concrete in 1 hour. And in case of RM 1400 model, you will be get 17 to 20 meter cube of the concrete. Now the another thing is that which type of the motor will require, how much the power will require, 10 HP. As the volume of concrete or mixing is increases, the HP is also required greater or larger. In case of if you want to produce 17 to 20 meter cube of the concrete, you will require 20 HP of the concrete. So why I am showing these technical specifications? So depending upon this technical specification, you have to calculate how much cost which is required to hire this type of the reversible concrete mixer. So always as a civil engineer, our responsibility is that we should know the output, this particular things, and the another thing is that the power consumptions. Okay, so depending upon that you can calculate the total cost which is required for hiring or purchasing this type of the reversible concrete mixers. Then this is the tilting type, you can say the concrete mixers. We can fill these particular mixers at the RMC plant, and then the transportation is going on up to your site. So if you see the technical specification about this type of the transit mixers, the model type is MTM4, and the normal capacity is 4 meter cube. And the if you see here, the geometric volume 9 meter cube. Then we have it is required, the power is 41 HP and the rotation is 2000 RPM. Okay, so the RPM is very important, revolution per minute. The drum speed is 0 to 14 RPM. Then water tank is 450 liters, and the water connection 50 mm. Okay, so the water pipe you should have the 50 mm. Then the water meter 20 meter cube per hour we required. Okay, in 1 hour how much water we required, 20 meter cube. Then 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liter. Okay, so in 1 hour what should how much the water will require for mixing the concrete, we will see in these particular technical specifications. Then we should know the water pump 250 liter per minute. Okay, the length of the mixers is 5000 mm, the width of the mixers is 2300 mm, and the height of the mixers with respect to the truck, if you see here, 2500 mm. The weight of the mixers only, if you see here, 3200 kg. Okay, and the drum angle is 12 degree. So these are the technical specifications about, you can say, the transit mixer. Okay, now this is a summary of various of, you can say, the mixers for mixing the concrete. For mixing the ingredient of the concrete, the manufacturer use batch mixers or the continuous mixers depending upon the quality of concrete and the cost of work or project. Okay, the mixing of concrete is a wide topic and this issue has not been fully discussed here. Okay, there are many parameters like mixing time, mixing speed, then air pressure, and mixing pan and temperature, etc., which have an influence on the property of concrete. So always remember that the mixing time, then mixing speed, air pressure, and the mixing pan and the temperature, which influence the property of the concrete. So while mixing your concrete with the help of any types of the mixers, you should know these particular things. Then Dils G. De Schuttler and Vibor stated regarding the influence of the mixing procedure and the mixer type on fresh and hardened property of the concrete in the Journal of Materials and Structures. Okay, so those are interested, go through these particular journals, that is the material and the structures. In the same, the composition of concrete, the property of concrete or the mortar can differ due to the change in mixing procedure and the mixing type. Okay, hence it is very important to select the proper mixing procedure and the mixer type to mix the concrete. So as already I have mentioned regarding about the selection procedure, how will you select the different types of the mixers for mixing the concrete for any types of the project. Okay, so these are the summary for these type of various types of the mixers. Okay, so we have end up the different types of the mixers with these particular summary details. Okay, now the next important thing is that I would like to share with you the underwater concreting. Okay, so this is very important, underwater concreting. Okay, because now if you see here, I would like to read some of the particular things regarding about the underwater constructions. Now if you see here, I have one good paper. Okay, from AK Al Tamami in the development in the formulation of reinforced concrete. Okay, so this paper is published in 2008. Now in the introduction part regarding about the underwater concreting. Okay, so as per this technical paper, if you see here, what is the importance of this particular underwater concreting. Okay, now this article is we have started earlier underwater concreting. Okay, so what do you mean by the underwater concreting? It is the technique of placing concrete underwater for the construction means. Okay, so for any type of the civil engineering project, now if you see here, underwater concrete UWC. Okay, this is the one of the challenge in front of the civil engineers, underwater concreting. Now if you see here, it is a special type of high performance concrete. Now this type of underwater concreting we can use in the past, present, and in the foreseeable futures, as long as there is a need to construct bridge with foundation in soil with high water level and almost all off and on shore structures. Okay, so whatever may be the structure which is going on underwater, that is constructions of the dam, constructions of bridge piers, then constructions of the coffer dam. Okay, then whatever may be the civil engineering structure if you want to build in underwater, so what are the different types of the methods generally which is used to cast a particular foundation for a particular structures, all the technical specifications and methods are given itself in the in this particular article, that is UWC, that is underwater concreting. Okay, so the term high performance concrete refer to the concrete that perform particularly well in at least three key parameters or the key performance indicator, that is if you use any type of the concrete, you must you can say know the strength, workability, and the service life. Okay, whatever may be the cement and the different type of the ingredient if you use for underwater concreting, you should you can say adhere with this particular things, that is the strength, workability, and the service life. Service life means for example, if you want to construct a bridge pier, and at the time of design and analysis, the life of the bridge is 50 years, okay. So without any failure, the bridge pier should give the service up to the 50 years life, okay. Now in case of the dam constructions, now at the time of analysis and design, okay, at the time of design of the dam, if you design that particular dam for 100 years, so the dam should give the service up to 100 years without any failures, okay. That things we learn while doing the underwater concreting, that is the strength, workability and the service life. Therefore underwater concrete should meet these performance criteria, and it remains a viable and economic choice for the consultant and the contractor, okay. So now if you satisfy this, you can say the strength, workability and service life criteria, whatever may be the stakeholders is there in the you can say in our field, that is the contractor, then the consultant and various types of the engineers which is required in a particular project. So the economic choice will remain viable, okay. Then the underwater concreting requires special and careful monitoring during all stage of construction. So while doing the underwater concreting, a great care should be taken, because if you see for mixing the concrete, ultimately if you see the cost of the any type of the project, the material cost is nearly about 40 to 50%, okay. With the help of pie chart, we was seen in the last lectures the total cost of the constructions. So material plays an important role in case of any type of the project. So for the underwater concreting, we need to do certain careful monitoring during all the stages of the constructions, particularly special consideration for selecting the right materials, and then selections of good apparatus or the instrument for the quality control, then the design and the method of the constructions, okay. So underwater concrete was specially designed to enhance the constructability and the performance in water environment. Using the underwater concreting technique may avoid engineer using the old style of the constructions, okay. Now in the day by day, there will be improvement in case of the underwater also, that is the modern underwater concreting methods. So in this particular article we will see all the modern technology, all the modern methods underwater concreting, okay. Now the minimizing the eruptions to plant operation and result in high savings, okay. So in case of the UWC, underwater concreting is a highly flowable concrete, okay. The highly flowable concrete we have to use underwater concreting, that can spread into the place under its own weight and achieve good compaction in the absence of vibrations, okay. So whatever may be the concrete we are going to use in case of the underwater concreting, that concrete should have a flowable concrete, okay. Without exhibiting the defect due to the segregation and bleeding, okay. So underwater concrete technology has developed dramatically in the recent year, so that the mix can be proposed to ensure high fluidity as well as high resistance of washout and the segregations. So bleeding and segregation is one of the important parameters while doing the underwater concrete. The constructions of a wide range of the structure, including bridge pier, harbors, sea and river defense over many decades, and the development of offshore oil field has required the placement of concrete underwater. Now this process can be successfully carried out, and sound high quality concrete can be produced if sufficient attention is paid to the concrete mix design and the production method applied. So the stability of fresh concrete depends upon the rheological property and the placement conditions. Now it can be characterized by the concrete resistance to washout, segregation and bleeding, and it is affected by the mix proportioning, aggregate shape and the grading, mixtures, vibration and the placement conditions. So at this stage I would like to say the differential velocity at the interface between the freshly cast concrete and the surrounding water can erode some cement and the other fines. Such erosion can increase the turbidity and the contamination of the surrounding water and impair the strength and durability, as well as bound to the reinforcement steel and the existing structures. Therefore, the another thing is that the improvement of in situ property of underwater concrete is related to the enhancement in washout resistance. A superplasticizer, that is the SP, is used to ensure high fluidity and reduce water powder ratio. Then anti washout admixtures, that is known as the AWA, is incorporated to enhance the yield value and the viscosity of the mix and hence the washout resistance and the segregation resistance. The majority of the anti washout admixtures are water soluble polymers that increase the yield value and the viscosity of cement paste and the concrete. For this purpose, we required the statistical analysis. So this is about the technique of the underwater concreting. Okay. Now, if you see here, the effect on the workability of the underwater concreting. Few key variables have the most significant effect on the workability of underwater concrete. The first, you can see the effect of workability on underwater concreting. Workability means it is the ease with which we can do the work with the concrete. So these are the five key variables which affect the workability of underwater concreting. The first key parameter is that a water to fines the ratio of concrete. So a potable water we have to use in case of the underwater concreting. Okay. Then the particle packing characteristics. Okay. So while mixing, the greater care should be taken while mixing, and you have to select a proper, you can see the mixers for the mixing of the concrete. Okay. The third key parameter, that is the compositions and the content of cementitious materials. Okay. So the compositions and the content of cementitious materials we should know. The diffraction characteristics and the solid particle in the concrete, and when placing the concrete under water or slurry through a prefabricated reinforcing steel cage, the clear spacing between the steel bar should be at least 5 times the maximum nominal size of the coarse aggregate in the concrete. So these are the five key parameters we should know, because it will affect the workability of the underwater concreting. Okay. Then a problem is faced during the UWC, that is underwater concreting.
Hello?
The first parameter that is the problem is faced in the underwater concreting is that the segregation of fine aggregate from water pollution, then increase WC ratio and the washout. Okay. So the problem faced during the underwater concreting: segregation of fine aggregate from coarse aggregate. Generally, the sand is segregated from the coarse aggregate. This is the problem while doing the underwater concreting. So the care should be taken to avoid this problem. So we will see what care should be taken. Then water pollution should be there, because while underwater concreting, if you go deep and deep. For example, for 50 feet or more than that also, for the purpose of underwater concreting. Then there should be the water is coming from the underwater ground. Groundwater should come in your working area. Okay, so some water may pollute your concrete also. So water pollution will be there. So care should be taken to avoid such problem on the site. Then increase WC ratio. For example, if the water table is far near to the ground, okay, then ultimately some water may the chances of the groundwater may mix with your concrete mixes. Okay, then also there will be a problem of the increased WC ratio. Then washout, all the concrete may get washout due to the groundwater. So these are the problem generally we face during the water concrete. And if such problem is there, then ultimately you will waste your money for the various you can say the concreting. Okay, so ultimately you will lose your all profit in case of if such problem is arises during the underwater concrete. So you have to care should be about this type of the problems. Okay, then these are the limitations of underground. Okay, so situations where we can use the underground water concreting, generally in case of any type of the basement, for any type of the structure, if you want to construct a basement or foundations, then we require the underwater concreting. Okay, then for sewerage and marine works, so these are the situation where we require the you can say the underwater concrete. Then inspection of concrete during the placement underwater is difficult. Okay, so generally the inspection, okay, if the underwater concrete is going on, and if you want to inspect them, means the we cannot go down in the ground. Okay, there is no you can say the place for entering the man. So the inspection work is the limitations for this underwater ground concrete. Then the underwater concrete should have a slump of 100 to 180 mm. Okay, so if you see the slump value, and the slump value of concrete you should maintain between 100 to 180 mm. Then the water cement ratio should not exceed 0.6, and may need not need to be smaller. Okay, depending upon the grade of concrete or the type of chemical attack. Okay, then the another limitation is that for the underwater concreting is for aggregate of 40 mm maximum particle size, the cement shall be at least 350 kg/m³ of concrete. Okay, then for aggregate of 20 mm maximum particle size, the cement shall be at least 380 to 390 kg/m³ of the concrete. Okay, so taken in case of this proportion. Then the avoid the content of the coarse aggregate, okay, should be kept as low as possible. The code assume a maximum voids content of 55%. So these are the limitations of this particular underwater concreting, and need to take a great care regarding about this limitations while doing the underwater concreting. Then these are the topic we are going to cover in case of the underwater concreting. First is the introductions. Then certain concrete specification should be there. Then laying techniques, we have different types of the methods by which you can do the underwater concreting. Then certain repair works will be there, and we came across with the conclusion part. Okay, so these are the topic we will cover under the UWC, that is underwater concreting. Okay, in case of the introduction part, we have already started this particular underwater concreting. There are often situations such as basement, sewage, duct, harbors, bridge, and the marine works in which concrete is to be placed underwater. Okay. So the special precaution need to be taken whenever the concrete is to be placed underwater. The concrete should be plastic and the cohesive, but should have good flowability. Okay. So this is a part of, you can say, the underwater concreting. So these are the area where we can use the underwater concreting. Okay. The performance requirement for UWC, that is underwater concreting, the workability and self compactions. So as far as civil engineering point of view, the workability and self compactions, these are the requirement for underwater concreting. The workability means it is the ease with which we can do the work, and the self compaction is the requirement. Then cohesion against washout and segregation. Okay. Then low heat hydration. Okay. Then control set time. Then the compressive strength and the adequate bond. So while doing the underwater concreting, we need to study this performance. Okay. So these are the major performance, you can say, during the underwater concreting. You should know the compressive strength of the concrete, adequate bond should be there, then control set time should be there, low heat of hydration. So these are the performance requirement for underwater concrete. Then again, these are the problem faced, we have discussed earlier, segregation of fine aggregate from coarse aggregate, water pollution, increased WC ratio and washout. These are the problem faced during the underwater concreting. Okay. Then the type of material which is used in case of the underwater concreting. Okay. Cement, then coarse aggregate, fine aggregate and the admixtures. So these are the materials we have to use for the underwater concreting. Then if you see here, the type of cement used in case of the underwater concreting, the ordinary Portland cement, that is OPC. Then we have to use the sulfate resisting Portland cement, SRPC. Okay. Then low heat Portland cement, LHPC. So this is a favorite questions, you can say, when if you want to give the interview in case of the any type of the company. Okay. So this is a probability that they will ask you, so which type of cement you will use in case of the underwater concrete. So these are the, you can see, the good type of the cement we have to use underwater concreting, UWC. Okay. Then the another material, that is the aggregate. Okay. These are the ingredient of the concrete, coarse aggregate. If you see here, certain technical specifications about the coarse aggregate. The coarse aggregate for introduced in the concrete shall conform to the following gradation. The maximum size should be 1.5 to 2 inch. Okay. 100% shall pass a 75 mmcu. Okay. So this is the specifications regarding about the coarse aggregate. Then minimum size, material passing through a 90 mmcu, okay, and should not exceed 5% by mass of the coarse aggregate. So these are the two important things we should know regarding about the specifications for the aggregate. Okay. In case of the fine aggregate, we should know certain specifications. The sand of the introduced grout shall be well graded, preferably of sound grains, and shall conform to the following gradations. Okay. So these are the gradation in case of the fine aggregate. Passing, the fine aggregate should pass through 1.18 mmcu, that is 95 to 100%. Okay. And then the another, you can say, the specification, passing 600 micron CU, that is 60 to 85%. And then the another criteria, passing 300 micron CU, 20 to 45%, okay, and passing 150 micron sieve 15 to 30%, and passing 75 micron sieve 0 to 10%. So while grading the fine aggregate, you should know these are the criteria of the grading, okay. Then the use of different admixtures. So we have to use the certain type of the admixtures to you can say the increase the strength of the your normal concrete. So the anti washout admixtures will be there, the hydrosim and mellows. So these are the anti washout admixtures which help us in case of the these particular problems. Then the viscosity modified admixtures, okay, that is naphthalene, formaldehyde, okay, then sulfonated melamine, formaldehyde. So this type of the you can say the admixtures we have to use to modify the viscosity of the concrete, okay. So for anti washout these are the two admixtures, and in case of the viscosity, if you want to modify the viscosity, we have to use the this type of two admixtures, okay. So these are the admixtures we have to use in case of the underwater concreting. Then the important thing is that the methods of underwater concreting, okay. So generally we have three types of the methods, okay. So this part we will cover in the next lectures. So before closing the today's lecture, I would like to ask you some of the important questions here. So the first questions I would like to ask, which method is not in a common use in case of placing concrete? So this will be we will cover in the next lectures, okay. So this is the question for today's class. Underwater concrete should have a slump of mm to mm, okay. So anybody unmute and tell me, for the underwater concrete the slump value will have, or the slump value should be between, you have to select any one options and tell me. Anybody unmute and tell me which slump value which required underwater concrete. Now I expect this answer from the class, okay. Anybody unmute and tell me. Underwater concrete. Yes, yes, please go ahead.
100
but your voice is breaking, huh? I can't hear you properly.
B answer. B,
B answer.
Option B.
Okay, okay. So 100 mm to 180 mm is the correct answer. So everybody should know this is a particular answer, okay. So for the underwater concreting, we should keep the slump value in between 100 mm to 180 mm, okay. So this is a particular questions. Now all these questions are very important. Why? Because I would like to give you notice regarding about our CA1, okay. So our CA1 generally based upon we will take our CA1 on gate tutor, okay. So in between 1 October to 10 October we will take you can say the CA1 on gate tutor, okay. So I am going to you can say set your question paper tomorrow, and I will give you the date for the particular you can say the test, that is CA1. Okay. So if anybody is want to discuss regarding about the CA1, okay, so we will select the date. So which date you will prefer? Unmute yourself and tell me the feasible date as per your schedule also. Okay, so we will take the test in between that. Okay, so which date is feasible as per as your you can say the schedule point of. So anybody unmute and tell. Yes, yes.
Sir, 10.
But the test we will take in our regular lectures only. Okay, so we will have a 30-minute. Okay, and the test is on GateTutor. Okay, so tomorrow I will going to set a test paper. Okay, so the test is base is the test is based upon the objective type questions. Okay, so there will be 50 questions. So out of the 50 questions, the 10 questions is randomly coming, and you have to give the correct answer. And this is a pattern of our test. Okay, actually, so I will set the test paper, and we will see. You can say, or I will also post the same question. Same means 70 questions. Okay, objective type on our team in our channel. Okay, so you will refer those questions and prepare for your CA1. Okay, so this is the notice from my side. I will declare the exact date. Okay, in the next lecture, that is at on incoming Saturday. So if anybody have any questions for today's lectures, please ask the questions. Otherwise we will close the today's lecture. If anybody is having,
sir,
yes, yes.
Sir, 10 marks ke liye 50 MCQs kya?
No. That question is randomly coming. Any 10 question will come. Okay, and the test is on GateTutor. So, yes. Now, if anybody want to ask any questions, please ask. Otherwise, we will end today's lecture. So, thank you very much.